This is the Dollamore Daily, and I'm Jesse Dollamore.
We know that intellectually vacuous conservatives have tended to swim in the warm waters of hypocrisy for quite some time now. However, in the era of Donald Trump, they're submerged in these waters. The waters of conservative hypocrisy are now so natural and comfortable for them, it's like amniotic fluid. They live in it. They breathe it. They thrive in it. I've not done a count, but I'm sure I've done dozens and dozens, maybe hundreds of videos, which either directly or indirectly address their rank hypocritical hot takes. Well, you can add this to that ceaselessly growing list. Because of all the gaslighting indignities that have been visited upon us by the Trump horde, this ranks up there with among the most egregious. You see, the other night on Sean Hannity's Propaganda Hour, he used his hot air balloon for a head to posture a little thought experiment. Hannity, in a failed attempt to paint Joe Biden and his son as corrupt, wanted his audience to imagine, if they could, if Donald Trump Jr. or Eric or Ivanka were raking in untold wealth from foreigners while their daddy was in office high atop the executive branch of government.
Quote, James Biden made it clear he viewed the fund as a way to take money from rich foreigners who could not legally give money to his older brother or his campaign account. We've got investors lined up in a line of 747s filled with cash ready to invest in this company. The executive quotes James Biden is saying. Now, can you imagine, just stop for a moment with all we just told you. What if the person was Donald Trump Jr., Eric Trump, heck, Ivanka, Barron Trump? Imagine how much the mob and the media would be obsessed with that story. Does that prove my point? Journalism's dead. You know exactly what they'd be doing, and they wouldn't be covering for Don Jr. They'd be fanning the flames.
Come on. Sean Hannity is a transparent simp. He may be able to fool the toddler brain cult members who largely make up his audience, who sit there in their living rooms transfixed by grotesqueries such as this. But the rest of America is collectively shaking its head at this nonsense. And listen, this isn't just a solo run at lying to the American people. Eric Trump, just the other day, told Yahoo Finance that his family would go down as one of the few families that have actually made a tremendous sacrifice while their daddy served in the White House.
The huge irony of the whole thing is when you have a son of a top politician of the U.S. sitting on the board of a company getting paid $600,000 a year with no understanding of the language, no understanding of the industry at hand, and no discernible duties. I think Americans, I think probably everybody in this room being in the real world, I think you probably look through it and say, come on, give me a break. You know, something fishy is happening here. When you have Nancy Pelosi's son who's sitting on the board of energy companies, right, while Nancy Pelosi actively goes out every single day, you can't drill for oil in upstate New York, totally fine, right? But you can't drill for oil in upstate New York, you can't frack, but it sure as hell okay if my son sits on an energy company, on the board of an energy company in Ukraine. I think people find that pretty hypocritical. And all I'm saying is, I think if you look at our family, and whether you're, guys, I'm actually probably a lot more centrist than everybody would otherwise surmise, you know, seeing us on TV. In all fairness, I was born in New York, but I think we'll go down as one of the few families that have actually made a tremendous sacrifice getting into business. We've lost a lot of money, I'm sorry, into politics. We've lost a lot of money based on the fact that we don't do any deals, that we're sitting silent, you know, while he's in there, that we're not sitting on boards, we're not doing what all these other people are doing. And I think there's a lot of people on the opposite side of the table who are, you know, their parents get in or they get in, and all of a sudden, you know, listen, how is Nancy Pelosi worth the amount of money that she's worth if she's been in government for the last long period of time? And what I'm saying is there's a lot of dirty money in politics, and I think people need to realize that, and I think people are finally starting to see through it, and that has to change in this country.
All of this is garbage. Utter and complete bullshit. You see, we don't have to imagine what it's like to have an allergic to ethics president in the White House, a man who raised his sons to be grifters and thieves, and reared his daughter to keep the family con going. And they are performing admirably in this regard. While Donald Trump has been president, Ivanka, an official advisor to the President of the United States, who frequently has public as well as private access to world leaders and international corporate chiefs, is amassing dozens and dozens of trademarks for herself, often having her applications for them approved immediately after her meetings with these leaders, which is an insane and unprecedented approval timetable. For instance, back in 2017, according to the Los Angeles Times, on the same day Trump and his daughter dined with Chinese President Xi Jinping at Mar-a-Lago in Florida in April 2017, China awarded her three preliminary trademark approvals for jewelry, handbags, and spa services. In all, she has obtained more than a dozen Chinese trademarks since entering the White House, ensuring her access to the world's second largest economy if she goes back into business. And that was just the beginning. You see, Ivanka's trademarks in foreign countries have been steadily piling up, starting the moment Donald Trump became commander in grift of these United States. According to the Ethics Watchdog, Center for Responsibility and Ethics in Washington, or CRU, Ivanka Trump Marks, LLC, applied for these Japanese trademarks on November 9, 2016, the day after Donald Trump won the U.S. presidential election. The trademarks received approval on February 2nd and February 16th of 2018, around the time of Vice President Mike Pence's February visit to Japan and meeting with Japan Prime Minister Shinzo Abe. Abe also met with Ivanka Trump herself in 2016 when she accompanied her father to his first face-to-face meeting with a foreign leader as president-elect. This meeting occurred roughly 1 week after her company applied for the trademarks that recently received approval. Ivanka Trump Marks LLC won approval for several Japanese trademarks in 2017 as well. In fact, ethics expert and spokesman for CRU, Jordan Leibowitz, said the sheer number of foreign trademarks Ivanka Trump has gotten while working in the White House would be troubling enough. But the fact that she just got one for charitable fundraising when her father's namesake foundation, which she served as a board member for, and is closing in scandal following a New York Attorney General investigation outlining numerous legal violations, is especially troubling. And this is only dealing with her trademarks. I'm not even talking about the astronomical cash she's making apart from them. She is raking in millions of dollars from the Trump hotels, which are being stayed in by Republican Party bootlickers, corporate suck-ups, and foreign officials who are all trying to curry favor with Donald Trump while he sits in the Oval Office. But according to Sean Hannity, can you imagine if the president's rich entitled brats profited from his office? Gross. And clearly, it goes unsaid that Ivanka is not the only product of Trump's sour loins that is running a global grift. Desperate to be smart Eric and desperate to be a tough guy Donnie Jr. are constantly globetrotting, often hitching rides for free on Air Force One in an effort to profit from their daddy's position in the White House. Also from the Los Angeles Times, Eric Trump and his older brother, Donald Trump Jr., run the Trump Organization, which conducts business and takes in tens of millions of dollars annually around the globe and is still owned by the president. The company is forging ahead with projects in Ireland, India, Indonesia, and Uruguay, and is licensing the Trump name in such turbulent areas as Turkey and the Philippines. Look, we know that Donald Trump Jr. and Eric are going around the United States and the world efforting to make as much money as they can while their soon-to-be impeached pop remains in the White House. After all, they run the company which Donald Trump still personally profits from and from which he refused to divest himself. According to reporting from the New York Times, in August, President Trump's eldest son, Don Jr., flew to Jakarta to help kickstart sales at a pair of Trump-branded luxury resorts planned for Indonesia. He appeared at a private event with wealthy prospective buyers and joined his politically connected billionaire Indonesian business partner at a news conference. And last year, Donald Jr. visited India to sell condos at future Trump-branded towers, appearing at an event that also featured India's prime minister. The facts are these, and they are self-evident, Sean Hannity, you pumpkin-headed puke. The family to whom you've pledged your undying fealty is doing the very thing you're accusing the Bidens of doing. The clock is ticking, and time is drawing nigh. Soon, Trump will be out of office, and you will have to propagandize for something or someone else.